So, first of all, welcome to my session. So, in this session, we're going to talk about the Progressive Web App and our new journey. Thanks to the Tolkien, there is a movie probably you have seen already. The Hobbit is getting a new journey. We're going to follow the same footsteps on this journey. By the way, this is me, Salim Kayabashi. You can find me on Twitter or Google Plus, whatever. And I'm the Google expert on the web technologies. And you can send me an email, just salim.kayabashi@gmail. I want to remind you as a little bit from the movies. And one day, Bilbo Baggins was in living his home, and suddenly the dog is knocking. And he came out, there are a lot of dogs, and they want to make a journey to some reason. And after they talking, they realized that they have to beat a dragon, which was the smoke. So as a developer, I think that at this journey, there are some developers on the side, and we came up to, and learned something about the progressive web app, like the dogs. And we have some features, for example, at the home screen or service worker. So at the end of that movie, he beat the dragon. And he has some footprints, and we have to follow them. In this session, I'm going to give some little bit details on the progressive web app, and then showing some demo, and doing some code. If you want to check what was the progressive web app and the more details, please check his guy's sessions. He's going to make more details. So basically, what is the progressive web app? We are still developing web. And we are serving a new user experience for our customers or other clients. The important part, I think, the user experience. So what are the key points for the progressive web app? I think the offline capabilities could be important for your web, because most of the people who are using your Android or iOS native application, because of the offline capabilities. So for example, in Twitter or Facebook, you can check your tweets when you are offline or online. So we can make it on the website and load more faster because of using the app shell or something different technologies. You can cache your content and show it a little bit important. And with new at the home screen feature, your content can be accessible just one tap behind. While we are talking about offline capabilities, when you look at all your experience while using your applications, I mean the native one. So I think the main content could be important while you have no connection. For example, when you go to your work, you have to use a metro bus or metro like that. You have no connection, and you want to read your text and your content or article could be important. And installing an application in your devices that makes a bridge between your customer and your application, because of this engagement, you can reach your customer in every way, because you're so close to your customer, just one step behind them. With these all the features, your phone and your website could be accessible and reachable behind the normal web page. For example, it can work in a full screen mode, and it can load like an application, your content can be reached offline. So in this session, I'm going to use some kind of code, and I'm going to use a WebStorm for my demo. I'm going to show you a lighthouse, because when we started the journey, we needed a lighthouse to show our road. Do we have that one? I think we have. There's a Chrome extension. You can install your Chrome. And I already installed. I'm going to show it. Let me open some application. Yes. Right here, I have an application which is about Dragon. When you close the DevTools, there's a lighthouse icon here. You can start generating a report. It will automatically generate a report for you, which is calculating a score for you. And testing your web page, detecting the features related about the progress of the web, and it's going to show a report. Yes, we got score on 24. It's okay. We're going to fix it. So it says there is no service worker. Okay, I got it. And there is no offline support. Okay, you can fix it. We got some points, and there's no SSL, I think, and there's no manifest exit. Okay, we can find. So, let's go back to the slides. Okay, Lighthouse shows us that we need to fix something, but these are not certain rules you can use. And here's the link for our demo. You can download it. Just a basic application or website. It contains just only three HTML files, and I'm going to use another kind of extension, a web server for Chrome. You can search online. Just a basic HTTP serving with a given static folder. For example, I'm using that folder to serve on that port of my localhost. Yeah. There are a lot of other inside here, but if I show you this way, yes. I'm going to start with this folder, which is Word. As you can see, there's a Dragon HTML, FAQ HTML, and index.html. Let me open it, and it's still running with this extension. Can you check out? Yeah, we have the website. Now, I want to emulate it as like a mobile phone. As you can see, this is showing the Nexus 5X. And do you think these links are suitable for the clickable for the mobile site? And for example, all the images are looking a little bit smaller. Progressive web apps does not mean just using the service worker. Your website should be responsible for the mobile design. So I'm going to add, if I find my devices, I'm going to add some basic code lines, like here, inside here. Basically, it says, hey, please, change my viewport. Please, do not scale, and it should feed my device with. And I'm going to use a manifest file. And what's the manifest file? It's going to show some details about your progressive web app. There's a tab here, maybe you can see it like this. And when you click on the application, on the manifest, actually there is no manifest file, it shows nothing. So we have to add some manifest file here. Maybe. Yes. Here's the difference between two branches. I added one manifest file. There is only one JSON file. It shows some name, short name, display, blah, blah. There are too many options, but we are going to just using a few steps. We need an icon for our web application, and I gave it a start URL, which is going to be related path. And I added some background color and theme color, and I have short name and full name. I'm going to show the details. And like I told you, I have three static pages, and I have to add these two lines for the old pages. As you can see, both of them are the same. So when we load our page, as you can see, these links are more clickable and the showing image a little bit bigger. And we have a manifest file. It can read automatically our emojis and the long name. As you can see, start URL is working. Now we can try again. What was our score and what is the current score? Yes, got it. Just on adding a few lines. Wow, that was good. Okay, let's do something special. Okay, we added a place manifest file. We became a little bit mobile friendly. So, what's the details? So, as you can see, we are starting from the work, and I'm going to show it using my phone. There's a feature for the debugging if you have a Chrome installed your device. You can check Chrome inspect devices. It will show automatically your connected device. It should. Yes, here we go. But let me check again. Yes, got it. Okay. It's showing the Chrome tabs on my devices. I'm using the Chrome Dev, the latest version. And I have to use the port forwarding, the local port, not this one, this one. The local port on my computer is this one, and I can use this port on the Android devices. So I'm closing all the tabs and the opening localhost at 30 down below. Okay. Yes, I got it. Probably hard to see, but I'm going to open. Yeah, you got it. So, we can debug it or inspect. Now we have the same content as always. Maybe I have to unregister. Okay. So why it should work within a mobile device? Because some features are related about mobile settings. Like I said, I added some theme color and background color and icon and some short title here like that. We can use all of them, and if while working your devices, you can trigger at the home feature from your computer. Oh, it's yeah. Okay. Probably. Fire badge, but not loading. Okay, it's okay. So, let's continue with working with the service worker. Basically, service worker working as a background service for your web server, but it has no access to the DOM. But the just adding a few lines, like here. You have to register your service worker. Basically, you have to tell, hey, navigator, if you have a service worker implementation, please register my sw.js file. Done. When it's done, please save it, it's okay. Yeah, we are going to try that one. Go to the step two. And when we check the difference between step one and two, yes, there's only two files. There was a JS file which has name site.js. I just edit the same code lines that I showed in the same presentation. It's going to load SWJS. And what's inside the SWJS? Nothing. To be honest, no need to do inside the your service worker, but registering is okay for the lighthouse. if we rerun, it's going to try to register our service worker, and it has no idea about the, what is the service worker and what are the abilities, and looking for the more details, but couldn't find it. Yes, we got more points, but totally fake. So we have to add something, I think. And by the way, you can check the old service worker in your browser. For example, this is the our latest, and the Chrome Horner, Air Horner, another example. And we have more. Probably you're already using the service worker, but you have to, you don't know idea what's the service worker. After adding service worker, you can try at the home screen feature. Like here, on my desktop, on the application tab, at the home screen. As you can see, there's a notification over there. You can add your application on the desktop. Click on the add. It's going to use the long name of your application with a given icon. If you add it, you're gonna see there's an icon for that. And when you look at the Chrome apps, it will add it automatically, like an application. When you click on it, basically opening your application in the full screen mode. If you wanna check that on your mobile device, yes, we can trigger here. Yeah, not showing over there, but you can see at the home feature is still here. Like the same, because at the home screen, it's gonna do the same thing after adding. Okay. So we can continue with showing the push notifications. Push notification is another feature of the progressive era. So many people think that the application cannot send a push notification for the devices, and using the native application makes a bridge between the customer and your application. So this is quite wrong. You can send a push notification to your desktop or the client's mobile side with using their your web application. As you can see, if you want to register your service worker with a push notification implementation, that way page has to request your permission. For example, if you are using the Facebook on desktop or the WhatsApp on web, it may require your push notification permission. And if you get a notification on your mobile device, it's quite same with the native applications. So how we can do that? Same again, you have to talk with the service worker. Hey, service worker, if you're ready, please register my push manager. And you have to say, hey, push manager, could you give me subscription details? It's going to be given subscription object. It may difference which browser that you are using now. And possibly, they're going to be similar, or they're going to be joined all the browsers. For example, if you are using the Chrome or the Firefox, it doesn't matter. You are going to put on the same object from the subscription. This subscription just showing that browser. If your customer has to use their another device, they have to register again. So we are going to add this feature on our application. Going to step three. Let's check out the, what's the difference. Okay, I added just one line, like GCN sender ID, just a random number. You have to register on Google Cloud Messenger, and you have to register your project, and you will get a project ID, and I just take a number. And after adding that number in your manifest test file, your browser can understand and register your client as a push server. And at Site.js, after registering our service worker, just copy and paste the same code base. Like here, please service worker registration, please give me the subscription object. Okay, we can check it. And what's inside the service worker, you have to listen the upcoming push notifications. So in our service worker JS, we have to add an event listener, which calls a push. When we get the push notification event, I'm showing the static the push notification. So let's try it. Under DevTools, you can send it immediately. As you can see, this is the log for our SWJS. After registration, we got an excellent message. And after that, we got a subscription object about the push subscription. So if you want to send a notification to your user, you have to request at that URL with the given credentials from the Google Cloud Messaging. And by the way, no need to implement that, but we can send push notification here just for the demo. As you can see, there's a trigger for the push. Yes. As you can see, we got the push notification right on the side. It depends on what operating system that you are using. For example, on the Mac, it's showing in the top on the right. It's the quite native push notification. And as far as I know, they are going to merge with the Windows Notification Center and the macOS Notification Center very soon. So let's check again our Lighthouse score. Now we can send a push notification and we can respond and show our content. Still generating the reports. Again, higher score. Yes, still same. Okay, when we check the highlighted error, it says there's no offline support, and we got some points. Okay, maybe we can add some offline support. By the way, I want to show you sending push notification to mobile devices. Yes, I got another push subscription object. I'm sending push notification. I have a lot of notification, but we'll show. Okay, not working. Never mind. So we added the push notifications. We got our push notification and showing its details. Just a basic JSON declaration. You can check all the details on the GCM. And you can send the title and the message body with given URL. And you can add just one static icon over there. There's a screenshot for you, and if you are sending a push notification on your mobile device, you have to give a permission saying delay. And if you got a push notification, it says sending from Chrome Dev with given URL address. So your user can understand which website are sending the push notification for you. And there's a site settings button over here. You can reject the upcoming push notification and you can delete your permission like that. So it's time to add offline capabilities for projects. That was, I think, easiest way to implement it, because you have to add an event listener, we call it an install. After installing our service worker, we can open a cache, we call it the magic cache. You can think that this is a static folder for you, and you can add some URLs, and it will automatically fetch and store it inside that cache. Let's add this to our code base. Let me check the difference. This is quite same. And there is another event listener here. You want to register event listener on the patch. If your browser, while loading your website, it's going to use and request some static files like JS files and PNG and GIF files. For example, your event has to be matched with your previous request. If you have the same response in your cache, you can respond with the cache. Otherwise, it's going to fetch your request from your server. So let's check it. Does it work or not? So you can try. So I think it's working. To be sure, you can change the network settings and set it offline. It's still working. And there's a different thing. Now you block the network connection to your Chrome and your website. By the way, there's another option here on the application tab. You can set offline just for your service worker. Your website still can reach to your content, but you can block your service worker. And by the way, this option could set it offline your website. You can change here and here. As you can see, let me set it offline. It's not working. To be sure, we can disable our server. It's still working. Is it okay for us? All the static files are cached already, but in some cases we need to request some real-time data and updated content. For example, when we go to the Dragon page, we will see the Dragon game, but we are offline. So as you can see, we are offline now, but couldn't connect the Dragon status. We want to fetch it. So, okay, we have to fix it. In some case, make it online. It's gonna load some data, and when you click some buttons, we are getting some response. Like here, when you clear it, when you click on it. If you feed our Dragon, it's gonna be request some endpoints. So we have to add some exclusion for our code base. Yes. Basically, we can manage our requests because of the service worker is a kind of request proxy. If our event request URL contains a given URL, we can manage our data. If there's a problem, we couldn't reach our content, we can just give a static response for us. When we add it to our code base, just in the service worker, just edit here some complaints. On fetch event, please check the URL. Is this the same URL that I give? And after, please respond with the my cache. If there is no cache, please say my response to the user. And if we check and setting again, make it offline and reload again. It says to register. Okay, registered and offline. Let me reload it. Yeah, it says like that responding to the Robin server fetch with the service worker. It's going to respond with the service worker. I set it offline, but still can't be, Here's the my demo. We made some features for our just basic static page. We add some HTML tag for the responsive, making responsive a little bit, and adding it just manifest file to describe our feature and some giving instruction. For example, we added some background theme and theme color and starting URL. By the way, your user can just click by clicking, they can reach your content by offline, and with your service worker and the push notification feature, you can send the push notification to user just in a few minutes. So I want to show just a bonus feature for you. Probably you haven't heard of that page, pokedex.org. That's the progressive web app again. If you are using the Chrome there on the Android, there is a hidden flag inside the Chrome. If you enable this feature, it says enable improve at the home screen feature. When you try to add the home screen, it's little bit slowly things are adding. The basic way, it's adding your icon into your launcher. It should reach from the root. If I can show you. All the way, your icon should be listed here, but it cannot be listed inside your launcher like the regular application. But after enabling this feature, it can allow and install like a native application. You have to install, and after installing, you can open as a native application. And it's working as the same. You can search and find your application inside your launcher, and you can uninstall and check its version. And there looks like an amazing. Maybe you heard the Flipkart has an application on the native side, and they have a progressive web. When you check out the different sites, native application, I think, using over than 80 megabytes on the Android, but their progressive web just using under the 1 megabyte. That's all, I think. Do you have a question? Okay, yeah.
This progressive web app features can work on with iOS devices?
Ah, good question. Okay, if you are talking about Chrome on iOS, yes, it works. But if you are talking about the Safari on the iOS, no. The same problem with on the Safari on the Mac. They have no implementation for the service worker, but it can work the Opera, Firefox, also Microsoft Edge.
Will it be configured with Safari next year?
Some people are planning to bring some feature to the Safari, but Apple don't think the same way. I think probably they're building a new way for the service worker. I have no idea.
Thank you.
But as far as I know, because of the WebKit, Opera and Firefox, and they are still good, and the Microsoft Edge is working with the Chrome team, and they are still a little bit need to be improved, but they are good. And on Safari, actually I have some demo if you want to check. On Safari we can use all the features with using the, on iOS we can use all the features if you are using the Chrome. Yes, another question.
Is it possible to find interactive or distribution applications
we are
missing?
So I don't.
Is it possible to send rich or
depends on your implementation. You can send it just a basic JSON file, just contains the title, body, and the icon. These are all. When you click on it, it has to be responsible to open the given web page, that's all. If you want to make something interesting or interactive, you have to take care which page should open and what is the implementation on that page. Do you have any questions?
When we go on to the desktop, when we add this, to the desktop, is it possible to send the notification offline? Like, if, whether we're on the Chrome or not?
Okay.
If the browser is open or not?
Okay. Service worker can work your Chrome is open or not. That means you can send a push notification if Chrome is open or not. The other side, you cannot send a push notification if your user is offline. By the way, you can use geofence. The geofence is another feature of the Progressive Web App or Service Worker. For example, on the Android devices, if still they have online, but if you get a notification about the geofence, you can send automatically, but internal way, send a push notification. Like I'm saying, the push notification, just clicking on the link on my Chrome tab. So you can send something, but if you want to send something from your server, your user has to connect to the Wi-Fi or internet. Yes?
Are you saying that the watch notification ID is free for Google for the improvement, or should I pay for the service?
As far as I know, that should be free. And all the features are compatible with the Firefox and other browsers. But first you have to register for the GCM. Another question?
Yes. Do you think it's so there was like a lot of debate recently about this on native apps? Do you think it's the death of native apps?
Wow.
No, I mean, just what do you think?
Okay. In my opinion, it depends off your application and your product. Because, for example, you can beat the Facebook native application or the Twitter. No need to download and use that application. For example, I'm not using the Facebook application. I'm just using the Chrome tab. But for example, if you want to use Instagram, because you have to generate some, adding some image features, you cannot do that on the website, I think. You can, but using the native side could be easy for you. And I think user experience is the most important part of the decision, and it's related about your product and the customer decision. Some of the people can be not feeling good in using the website. Probably your previous website not suitable for the mobile friendly, and after that, if you are releasing some new feature with the Progressive Web, you have to prove that our website is not better. So they have to decide giving up your native application to switch back to the web application. I think this is my opinion. Yes.
In the mobile view, it will be a full screen view, or you have the URL in the top, like a browser.
Mm-hmm.
Is there like a browser or a full screen view?
Okay, you can decide it. I can show it. There's
in the mobile or the Chrome, there's no full screen view.
No, you can do. I'm just going to open the Pokedex.org. Actually, on the screenshot, you can see. Now, it's currently now in the website. I'm opening the Pokedex. You can try also. Pokedex.org. And after adding at the home screen, it's now installing as an application. I click on the install button, like installing as a native application. After installed, you can open it. There is no tab.
You scroll.
Yes, full screen.
You scroll. Scroll down after.
Yes. You can decide the behavior of the Chrome tab, just giving a specification on the manifest.file. Like say display command, it says standalone. There is no tab here. You can decide the behavior.
So the user won't know if it's an app or it's a Chrome tab.
Yes. So because of this feature, your user cannot determine is it native app or web, it's still okay if you are giving a good experience.
Yeah, that's the one.
Yes. Another? I think no. Okay, thanks for listening to me.